I mean, as a personal fan, bro, Coldplay has just, you know, been huge for my life. It's been like kind of like the soundtrack to my life, bro.
My manager too is his favorite band.
So can we talk about that, bro? Can you connect those dots?
This was 2017 now. So, you know, a little TMI. I was getting down with my wife and my phone kept ringing and I'm like, damn, like, come on, man. It was Gary, and Gary does not call like that unless it's something real important. And I called him back. He's like, yo, I need you to answer. He's like, yo, you're going to work with Chris Martin tomorrow in Miami. I'm like, what? He's like, pack your bags. You're on the flight in the morning. You're going to go work with Coldplay. Coldplay has a show in Miami, and they're doing a studio session. Wow. This was, I think, on a Saturday night. And Sunday, and then the show was Monday, and you're working tomorrow Sunday at Hit Factory with Chris and Tim. I was like, "What,
bro? What? It didn't register for a minute, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's far fetched." Yeah. I'm like, "Man, what? For real?" He's like, "Yeah, man. Pack your bags. I'm so happy. Favorite band." We started crying. I have a Coldplay poster that still hangs on my room. You know, I don't find it weird. I'm really a fan of that. And it's something that my wife and I connect over. Coldplay is very intimate to us because it's such a crucial part in our relationship. Like, one of our first days was a front row Coldplay show that I spent the last money I had on. But we drove to Cincinnati and we were at a Coldplay show front row. And then we did Lollapalooza, same. We went out there with no money. We slept in the car in Chicago.
To see your favorite band.
Yeah, to see our favorite band. So it's a very special group of individuals with a catalog of music that mean a lot to us. I had this poster and I'm sitting there and I'm like, babe, I'm gonna go meet Chris Martin tomorrow and work with Chris Martin. And I'm looking at the poster and we just start crying. Like, what?
Bro, I'm getting emotional right now too, bro. That's crazy.
That's crazy, bro. And I know it sounds emo. It sounds super emo, but bro, this is real. It's just real.
If you're human, you got to feel this story, bro. Yeah, this is a real one. This is great.
Show up to Miami, and Gary's amazing for doing this. He's like, I'm only going to tell you this, bro, because I don't want you to get shocked and I don't want it to affect you. I'm flying your wife down. You guys are going to be at the Coldplay show. We're treating your wife. This is a gift to you, brother. Kill the session. Don't be shocked when your wife shows up. Just pretend. Please pretend. I don't want to tell her. For all she knows is you're getting surprised, but I just don't want you to be shocked when you see your wife walk in. So show up to the session. There's Chris Martin, yo. Nicest dude ever. Mm. It was such a fun jam session. With Chris Martin, and this is something he explained to us later in the session. He describes it as like fishing. Look at making music, you know, like a fishing trip with friends. And he has this big smile, these big blue eyes. He's like, we're just showing up to fish. And some days you're going to catch big fish, or you're not going to catch any fish, sometimes medium fish. But one day you could really catch a real big fish. And it's all about having fun. Let's just throw our reel in and have a good time, guys. Thank you for being here. I'm Chris Martin from Coldplay. And that's how he gave us this lesson that I always tell people about. I'm like, yo, he's right. So we did the session. It went great. We did a bunch of ideas, just jamming. No pressure, just like, all right, next, Tim, crazy sounds, me adding my thing, Chris playing the piano right here, Dan doing his thing over there. It was organic and beautiful. We were jamming. It was just amazing.
No pressure.
Yeah. No pressure, just fishing, just That's having awesome. A good time. So then we go to the show, and they put us in a suite, the Rock Nation suite. For Coldplay, I wouldn't do a suite again. It was beautiful, because for Coldplay, man, we like being out there. That particular show, it started raining, pouring. And they didn't stop performing, bro. Chris was wet guitars. Like, it was raining down on them. And me and my wife were just so happy to be there, man. And during Magic, right before the record Magic.
You know, I just listened to that record before you got here, bro. That's crazy.
One of my favorite song. The way that record came about, it was a jam session that they were doing and that bass line. And then Chris recalled it 2 years later or something. And he told us a story about
it. Wild.
Crazy. But shout out to Tim and Angel in the middle of all these people at the Hard Rock Stadium. Literally shouts Timbaland and me out.
Crazy.
Which was insane because I managed to grab a clip of it. Someone had posted. I'm like, yo, he really just... I remember getting a text from Nick Valentin, my boy Nick, from Hit Factory, because he hooked everybody up from Hit Factory's seats. And Trevor was there. And Nick was like, yo, he just shouted you out.
That's wild, bro.
I was like, yo, Chris is the nicest person in life. Because they knew that, you know, my manager told him, like, yo, this guy is really a fan of you guys, like, big time. Mm. And his wife, too. And we went to the after party and my wife got to meet Chris Martin. And it was funny because every time Chris would turn around, she'd be like, that's him. Like, that's really, she's freaking out, you know, inside.
So we're a long way from Applebee's right now, bro.
Very long way from Applebee's, bro. Way, like, that was it. You know, now she's not working. You know, I was like, all right, I got you. She ended up getting sick. She had an ovarian cyst, and it was a very hard time for us. You know, we thought it was cancer. I mean, it was very scary times.
Is this happening right around the same time, by the way?
No, this was still Applebee's days.
Applebee's days.
And then literally, just to go back to that moment, when she couldn't work no longer because she had to have this surgery, that's when that money came in for Skylander. It was like God's perfect timing. Whoa. Man. It was wild. Gary was like, yo, Chris wants to see you and Tim again in Malibu. And on that day, Tim got sick on the way from Miami to over here. So he wasn't feeling well. He didn't make that first session.
Was it just you and Fede then?
It was just me and Fede. And Chris was ill too, but he showed up to the session. And I was like, oh, it's not, I don't know if it's going to happen. And he already knew me. He hadn't met Fede, but we started jamming, man. And we just crushed it.
You started fishing.
One of the songs that made it on the Coldplay album was from that day.
Crazy.
That it was just me and Fede.
What song is that?
Champion of the World. I started this drum beat. Just that groove. And then we just started jamming. And I ended up playing the electric guitar, which they kept on the recording. And guitar line. That was made from that first day. And I remember riding back through the canyon. It was a long drive because Fede lived in North Hollywood. And I was staying at an Airbnb. I was looking for an apartment already over here. We were talking. We're like, man, I think Chris loved us. And after that whole week, ended up being Thundercat was over there. Dav, who's a string arranger. Amazing composer for Coldplay. He did like Viva La Vida, all their string work. Crazy. Amazing. Bill Rako, Leon LaHavas was there with Thundercat. And it was like the craziest session. For a while, I remember Tim was like, we're just going to go outside and smoke and listen to these incredible musicians. Because it was literally a concert. Even Chris was kind of sitting out like, yo, this is insane. The most beautiful music. I wish I could go back just listen to some of those. I got to hit them up. But I remember going back after that week with Fede on the last night and we're like, man, I think Chris loved us. I think he's on call us back. And bro, like the month after, calls us back.
Chris hit you up or did he go through Gary or what?
We went through management.
Okay, went through management.
Yeah, but Chris, he already had my number and we have each other's number and we started working. And this one day they had this studio set up in one of his houses in Malibu. We had left. And I get a text from him. I wake up to a text from Chris at like 2 a.m. He's like, this song just came to me. Because Chris believes the songs come down to him and through him. And he was like, this song just came to me.
Yeah.
And he was like, it's urgent that you guys come. Can you guys please come tomorrow? I know it's last minute. Wow. So this was direct. So I hit Fed in, of course. I mean, we're all game. We love working with Chris. It's almost like spiritual and like in a musical way. It's just like no pressure and there's no better way of making music. And with someone who, to me, he's one of the greatest songwriters that we have on earth right now. Like without a doubt. So it's always a good time. And he's like, yo, this song came to me. So we show up and it ended up being the single that made it to radio from this last album.
Really?
Yeah, which had his son beatboxing. Boom, cat, boom.
What's the track called?
Orphans. That was the song. And we worked on it there. And then Max Martin ended up coming and rearranging. And
yeah. Hearing that backstory is so dope. Where it's like, it just came to him. He's like, yo, I know it's last minute, but we got to work.
Middle of the night, bro. It was a text at like 2 a.m. I woke up. Chris Martin, the song just came and it's unbelievable and it's urgent that we get it done.
A little voice note with the text message like, yo, here's the melody idea, you just trust
it. It's just like show up and we're like, dude, of course,
yeah,
we'll see you there 4 p.m drive over there. And we did the song and it's so amazing seeing Chris in the studio because the same energy he has on stage, it's in the studio. It's like he had the mic and he was performing the song like he was about to. The same energy, but it's just us and he's just running around.
That's awesome, man.
Such a good song, you know, and the fact that his son was a part of it and to see how happy he was about that.
That's so dope.
You know, to have little Mo on, it was like, boom, the cat. Boom, the cat, cat. Like having that groove,
How long does that surreal, trippy feeling stay with you, I wonder? Because again, like you had the posters up,
Does
that go away, bro?
Or is it still trippy? I got to take my wife to one of the sessions, which Chris was so cool to like allow me to do that. Because my wife, she knows the etiquette in the studio. Like you know. And I remember at one point turning around and she was just bawling quietly, but just crying, you know. And I asked her, I'm like, what was that like? And I wanted to do that because to me, it's rewarding. Like, I don't care about the money. It's moments like being able to take my wife, childhood bands, and her getting to meet. I got to take her to the Bahamas with Justin, and we had dinner by the water, and Justin was super welcoming, and seeing her meet, you know, these
especially knowing that, knowing the grind that she put in, exactly. Knowing the Applebee's.
And that's why it's important to me. And the fact that my friends, these artists, have been able to welcome that. You know, she went there for a couple hours and had lunch with us, but turning around and seeing our favorite band right there working on songs we're doing, to me, those are, that's why I do that.
That's bigger than dollars.
Exactly.
To me.